post. Peter Jerkins been a solid inside performer. Outside, it's Devontavius Payne.
Guy in the five, not too mobile. It's a good matchup.
Feeling it from three are the Bucks as Baker misses badly there. Bradford, nice slip pass inside. And Burrell with the layup right at the 10. And that's against a team that has got pretty good athleticism getting back into defense at 19-11. See if McLeod can be a spark. Just inside the three-point line, knocks down the jumper. Team Troy back on the attack. Nice no-look pass from Hicks. Inside reverse layup, B.J. Miller. And Troy out to a 24-13 lead. Counter move by the Bucks. Devontavius Payne. Drive got to the foul line. Bernardo again. Wide open for three and hits. When they're faced with dealing with an injury, but not him tonight. Now Payne comes back and drills the three. Give him nine in the first half. McLeod on the run out all the way to the rim. Banks it. Reverse style off the glass and in. Out of the corner, there's Wesley Person trying to get heated up. He's 0 for 3 from the floor now, but the rebound and stick back good for the Trojans. In any game this year, including tonight, that offensive board was his fifth. Pull up mid-range jumper fall.
Nice block out, nothing but maroon jerseys on the glass.
Nice one-handed roll pass. Too strong there. Offensive rebound, underhand move, and the lay-in good.
In the second defender off the floor.
Bernardo to the rim, lays it up with the right hand.
Players that can block shots is so good at creating angles and getting to the rim.
Spot up second half, four-point ball game. Three-point shot by Bernardo is good. Boy, what a rhythm breaker. Kicks out on the wing, now the redirect to Person, wide open for the three, and Wesley Person in the scoring column. Direct, 15 left to shoot. Off his own, missed free throw, hits the three. That's how you answer that call by your head coach. High lob to Bernardo. He'll attack the basket against three defenders, running one-hander. No, gets his own offense. Non-conference, try to get a litmus test against like opponent. Very conference-like game here tonight. A great finish near the rim.
Time that's remaining.
It's a great tempo rule. Person, spot up three, found it again.
Last four shots.
I believe you're right. McLeod with the kiss off the glass. Give him double.
Stinging in there. Takes some feel away. Too easy.
Person again. The knuckleball falls through. He's working against Long. Shakes him under a screen. Freeze. Right side. Are you kidding me?
You got it.
Williams on the handoff. Finds Bo Hodges. He'll get about the 4 foot line and get the floater to fall.
You want to keep the clock running. Bad foul by Davis.
Second shot, no good. The offensive rebound and the stick back on the redirect there for Bo Hodges. Points out of this opportunity. Obi Rapu for three, knocks down the triple, and that's how you draw it up. Steve Forbes calls a timeout, back to an 11-point game.
Foul there, you want to have somebody down there in case it comes off the rim hard.
Obi Rapu drills the three again. And yet, that has been one way or the other decided by less than 15 points. Obi Rapu not done yet, he's got nine. Skid on the road even to 3-3, Bucks fall to 2-3. With what will go down in the books as a 73-65 final score.
Looks and just didn't get a couple of those to drop for you early.
No, you know, our offense puts so much pressure on our defense. You know, we have to be able to score the ball. And you're right, I thought we had some good looks. But, again, you know, I have to do a better job of preparing our team. Obviously, I'm not doing a very good job of that because we're not converting when we're wide open, you know, and that's got – I got to find better ways for us to generate offense because what we're doing right now isn't working. And so I'm going to have to go back and study this thing and figure it out. And, you know, when you don't score the basketball like that for long stretches, it puts tremendous pressure on your defense. Our defense really probably was pretty solid for the most of the night, you know, except for when we let Person just go crazy there at the end. That was, you know, again, but yeah, so a lot of times with defense too, you have to put the game plan into the game. And when you're, and once a team starts, you know, stepping on you a little bit, you got to pick it up and you got to be more attention to detail. And we didn't. We just kind of shrugged our shoulders and allowed that guy to go crazy, which was really truthfully ridiculous, but was, you know, a great performance by him. He's a good player, don't get me wrong. He's a solid player. And so Bernardo is too. Those guys are – they played like all-league players. You know, lack of concentration, you know, at the free throw line, going 9 for 20, and we're a team that shoots plus 70 coming into this. And so, I don't know. I can't put – you know, it's like I got to put my finger on it. you know, sometimes it's like the dam that's got a bunch of holes in it. You kind of plug one hole and another one opens. You know, we just got to keep – the only way I know how to do this is to keep grinding, keep plugging, and figure it out.
Coach, talk about, again, the a lot of days quickly. There's a holiday. It's Thanksgiving. You got to you know, have the guys eat, got to practice, because Saturday coming in, Fort Wayne's a pretty good basketball team too.
Well, it ain't getting any easier, you know, and that's the whole thing. We'll practice tomorrow at 11, and then they'll have dinner. We'll provide them dinner, and then, you know, we'll practice Friday and get ready to play. And we'll have a couple more – one extra day to prepare for them than we did for this one tonight. But no excuses. I mean, you know, Troy played Monday too, and they played in Hawaii the week before. And that's a tough trip coming back. And they showed a lot of toughness tonight by coming in here and beating us at our house. And so, yeah, we'll have to practice tomorrow, and then we'll have to practice Friday and then get ready to go on Saturday. And I want to thank everybody for coming. I thought we had a great crowd. And, you know, we didn't really give them anything to cheer about, you know, and that's disappointing because we had tremendous support in here tonight. And I told our players that you can't rely on them to get you going. You got to do things to get them excited. And we did nothing of that nature tonight, in my opinion.
Coach, we appreciate the time tonight, and we'll talk to you on Saturday.
Okay, thank you.
Have a good holiday. Yep.